In this demo, I want to go through the process of setting up all of the data that you need to perform a certain calculation without necessarily doing that calculation just yet. I also want to show you how to structure a program so that user input can be added later on. You'll be doing this in the coming assignment and in many coming programs, so let's get things off on the proper foot. Think about doing math problems. What's often the hardest part of doing a math problem? It's not necessarily cranking the numbers out on a calculator. It's the upfront thinking work of setting up the equations or formulas that you need to solve. After that, it's cake. Writing a program is a similar kind of thought process. So let's go through that process on a very simple problem to see what it looks like. The first step in any problem-solving effort is to begin with a clear problem definition and a clear understanding in our head of what it is we're trying to solve. If the problem isn't clear in your head before starting out, you can't solve the problem. It's really as simple as that. So here's our problem that we want to solve. Let's say we're given a runner's mile time in minutes and seconds format, and we want to convert that time into an equivalent miles per hour pace and display the result. We know that there are 3,600 seconds in an hour and 60 seconds in a minute, so let's treat those as symbolic program constants. Now, we could crank this problem out with a little bit of thought and come up with a solution for any specific mile time. But we've got a computer programming language in front of us, so let's come up with a general solution, a computer program, that will work for any mile time. So out of this problem definition, let's start by homing in on all the needed data. I'm going to scroll down here a little bit, and here's the same problem description with the data identified here in color to make it a little bit more apparent. For example, we've got the mile time, which is a known, it's an input, and it's got two parts, the minutes and the seconds. We've got the miles per hour, which is the unknown or what we're trying to calculate. That's the desired result. And then we've got these two constants, which we've been told we need to treat as program constants. It might be helpful at first to jot the information down in a small list like this, but in reality, this is going to represent the thought process you'll soon be going through in your head. Trust me on this. Before we begin, you might also want to refer back to the data type definition logic tree, and here it is again for reference. You can find this in the data definition lecture notes and video, or in this week's course materials. But we're going to be making use of this logic tree in what follows. So let's think about these inputs. We've got the mile time in minutes and seconds, but let's say the minutes and seconds are themselves whole numbered values. So let's say that these are whole numbered values. So let's assign those to the int data type, and that's an int with a lowercase I. The miles per hour pace, if we're doing a calculation, chances are that's going to be some kind of decimal accuracy. Not spelling so well today. So let's treat that as a double data type. And finally, these two constants, these are going to be whole numbers. We'll also make those ints, but we said that those were constants, so we'll treat those as such in the program we'll be writing here in a moment. So again, these are the inputs, and the miles per hour is the output. So what we need now is we need some descriptive names for these things. So let's say something like, how about input minutes, input seconds, how about miles per hour pace, and remember the convention for constants that we talked about? Those will be in capitals and underscores. So let's say something like seconds per hour in capitals and seconds per minute in uppercase. Now we know that the values of these are 3600 and 60 respectively. What about the minutes and the seconds? Well, we don't really know what those are. Those are inputs and those are going to vary. And this is going to be a calculated value, so we don't know what that. But again, here's a first stab at taking this problem description and breaking it down into the needed data that we're going to need to solve a problem. So let's take this information in this table and let's turn it into the beginnings of a new program. And again, I stress that we're doing this just as an exercise. Soon enough, you're going to be going through this thought process in your head very instinctually. Trust me on that.